on just a moment. Okay, here we go.
Invite the youngest among us to come forward for the word for all ages.
Sunday of Lent. Does anyone know what Lent means or Lent is all about? Any ideas? It is the time before Easter, and it's a time when we think about Jesus and what he went through before Palm Sunday and before Easter and before Good Friday and before all that kind of stuff. So also, what else is today? What else is today? Starts with a V. Valentine's Day. So with Valentine's Day, we usually have like a heart, right? Yeah. So the scripture today is one that we did in church school 2 weeks ago, which was about Jesus' temptations in the desert. Remember where the devil asked him if he wanted to jump off a tall building and God would rescue, or someone, the angels would rescue him, etc., etc., and Jesus kept saying, no way, was it? Remember that? Okay. So that's kind of the scripture today. In church school, we're going to do two parables. We're going to do, in celebration of John Dominic Crossan, though we're not going to get into it that much. We're going to do the parable of the lost coin and the parable of the lost sheep.
Wow.
Oh, who has sheep at their house? You guys have sheep. Have you been losing any?
Nope.
Good. We don't want to lose any sheep. Definitely don't want to lose any sheep. So maybe later on, now they're too darn cute. So when we talk about Valentine's Day, we always talk about giving our heart to somebody.
Yes.
You have baby cows too. I saw pictures of them. They're so darn cute. I know. Okay, so let's go on. Okay. So when we say we're going to give our heart to somebody, we also sometimes give our hearts to things as well as people. And that's what Jesus' temptations were. The devil wanted to give him, to get him to give his heart to something else, and Jesus kept saying no. So sometimes we may want to give our heart to, what do you think this represents? It's a ball. Any ideas? Yeah, maybe we want to give our heart to sports instead of giving our heart to maybe God, right? Sometimes, who plays sports here? Who plays, like, soccer? You guys play soccer?
We're about to start soccer.
You are? I feel sorry for your mom and your dad, okay? No, only because soccer just sucks time out of the family because I was there. Okay. What else do you play? Soccer and what else?
Softball.
Ooh, softball. Can you hit the ball? Because I never could. Yes. Very good. Okay, so sometimes we want to give our heart into sports instead of to God. Sometimes we want to give our heart to, these are kind of silly looking sunglasses, right? They might represent
the sun.
The sun. They could represent the sun, absolutely. Also, they could also represent clothes and possessions.
Ooh.
But I'm not going for that, Jean Paul. All right, so sometimes we want to give ourselves up to, like, possessions, like jewelry, like clothes,
fashion,
like shoes.
Cars.
No, that would be good. I'm talking about stuff that may not be so good for you. But good, thanks, Donna. Yeah, kindness is awfully nice to do, absolutely. So anyone always want, do you guys always, sometimes you want something, like a clothing, like a dress, or a piece of jewelry or shoes. Sometimes shoes are great big temptations, right? They're always temptations for me. Unfortunately, I have to get stuck with boring ones. But so, anyone ever have that temptation? You nodded your head. Yeah. What about you? What about you, Greta? Do you ever get tempted into wanting stuff? Yeah. It's hard to say no, isn't it? Sometimes think, oh, I can do without that. So what other temptations? Sometimes we have temptations about this stuff. What is this?
Chocolate.
Candy, right?
Sweets,
cookies. Anyone ever give in to the temptation of sweets?
No.
Anyone out there ever given in to the temptation of sweets? Yes. Me too. But you know what? They say chocolate and red wine are good for you, so just go. Sometimes you want to give in to those kinds of temptations. And sometimes people actually do give things up for Lent. Have you ever heard of that? You give up something for Lent, for 40 days of Lent, like candy, like something. It's to kind of make you stronger. Have you ever heard of that? Sometimes people actually get things for Lent, and they say, I'm going to take on a certain task. I'm going to take on a task of saying hello to my coworkers every day instead of being a grump. I'm going to say hello to the kids at school every day. Or I'm going to give my best friend a hug every day. Right? Those are things that we can do for Lent. So we're going to talk about some of that stuff. But anyways, today's Valentine's Day. We have to give our heart to, who do we have to give our heart to? Starts with a G. God, yes, thank you. Yes, we want to give our heart to God. Okay, so let's say a prayer. Okay, ready? Oh, also I have to mention, out here in the narthex on the table between the doors, there's a Lenten resource table, and there's lots of things out there that you might be interested in getting and doing for Lent. So please stop by that table. Okay, ready? All right, Creator God, help us give our hearts to you and be thoughtful about doing it. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Okay.